bakakabirirwa.
Know the integrity of God's word.
Ziva chokwadi cha shokora mwari.
God's word is what it declares itself to be.
Dozari no taura ndozariri.
Key number two to developing a great faith. You have to know the reality of your redemption. Paul says, giving thanks to the Father, who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance, who has qualified us to know that in Christ Jesus we are redeemed from the authority of Satan. We have been translated to the kingdom of God's dear Son Jesus. Number three, know the reality that you are a new creation. When you received Jesus, you and I were recreated in Christ. In Adam we died, but in Christ we are made alive. Put yourself in Christ. Say hallelujah. And say, in Christ we can do all things. In Christ I am blessed. In Christ, hey, come on, I'm more than a conqueror. We also have to know that God says that you are the righteousness of Christ. Shout and say amen. You are the righteousness of Christ. And it's very important that you know that clearly. See, God himself is righteous. And he has become my righteousness. Now let me add this little thing. This is very important. Righteousness is not what you do. It's a gift. Because a lot of us get condemned and accused by the enemy. And we get all messed up. I really want God to bless me, but maybe the reason I'm sick is because I'm not good enough. I really want a miracle of $1 million, but hey, I need to become better. God has already made you righteous. He has already qualified you. Number five. Know the reality of the indwelling presence of the Holy Spirit.
1
John chapter number 4, verse number 4 says these words. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Number six, know the fellowship we have with the Father. See, a people who fellowship with the Father have no problem believing the Father for amazing things. The Father shares secrets with them. He reveals what he wants to do in their lives. Their faith is focused on God. The highest honor we can have as Christians is to fellowship with the Heavenly Father.
It's
number seven. I won't even preach on it. Know the authority of the name of Jesus Christ of
Nazareth.
Peter and John says, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give unto you. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Philippians chapter number 2, Paul says, we know that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, things in heaven, things under the earth, things everywhere, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord.
Dear Jesus, dear Isha.